Now, in order to write the code for count, you need to make a few changes in the show function. The changes to be made are, the name of the function becomes count. Second change, you don't need to display the first and the last elements separately, because here you are counting the elements, so you don't need this code. Similarly, you don't need this one. Now, here cout output operator dash means elements are not there, and if elements are not there, there isn't anything to count, so you don't need this line. Now here you are displaying the elements. In the new function, we need to count the elements, so this cout statement should be replaced with a C++. And when you write C++, don't forget, declare the variable and give the initial value 0. Now here cout output operator dash means elements are not there, so there isn't anything to count, you don't need this statement. Now associated with the if, only for loop is there. Associated with the for loop, there is only C++, so only one statement is there, you don't need this opening and closing curly bracket. Now in the else part, this cout should be replaced with the C++, because now you are not displaying the elements, you are counting the elements. Again, cout output operator dash means elements are not there, so there isn't anything to count, you don't need this line. Similarly, now you are not displaying the elements, you are counting the elements, so this cout must be replaced with the C++. Now variable C contains the number of elements in the circular queue. So in this else part, this is the opening curly bracket, closing curly bracket. So here you should display the answer, number of elements is equal to C. So in order to write the code for count function, remember the changes.